the Pecan Trail at Young Plantations. It's right behind us here. And we're going to find out about the pecan that's in this region and see how it's grown and
learn more about it.
So let's go in.
Let's go in.
Yes.
Here are the tasting samples for the pecan. Look at that. Pecan flavored key lime cheese jalapeno.
Jalapeno pecan.
Mild, actually.
Taking a sample of the pecan muffin.
You taste the pecan?
A little sweet, though.
We had a chance to talk to the manager there, who actually told us that there used to be, there is pecan that's grown in South Carolina, mm-hmm. and also different parts of the country as well. And Georgia was one of the places that she talked about.
Yes, that they get a lot of pecan from there. They used to say what she said, the shelling, which is basically getting the pecan
meat.
Out of the meat out of a shell. And now they are doing more of the retail side. So
yes.
They have a little bakery inside. They also serve some lunch. Meals. They also have ice creams.
Yeah.
And you get tons of sampling.
Yes, they have a sampling bar. Yes. So it's pecan from the nuts themselves, very sweet, into cookies and muffins,
savory
as well. So it was a lot of interesting. It's a great stop on this pecan trail.
Yes. So we got your second passport stamp.
Yes.
So now let's go to the next stop, which will be the market, PD market.
So we're driving into the farmer's market.
We are doing it. This is a drive-through farmer's market. Isn't that cool? PD Farmers Market,
which we just learned is one of three state markets in South Carolina. And
it's a drive-through market. Can you believe it?
Yeah, it's the first time I've ever seen a drive-through market. So you drive through their vendors.
You park on the side here.
Yeah.
You can drive through the middle and the vendors. Like Rosemary's saying, just on the side.
They're on the side and you jump out, you get what you need, and you jump back in your car.
Fascinating.
There's a lot of local products here. Here we are at the end of the week and it's almost time for the market to close, and it's rainy, so it's not quite busy today.
Yes, but what we hear is that it does get really, really busy.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes.
And it changes seasonally.
Mm-hmm.
So the vendors change all year round depending on what's in season.
Seafood restaurant where we're gonna eat for lunch, and it's called Tubb, Shrimps and Co.
Yeah, so we're excited, and we'll see you on the inside and show you what we're gonna eat.
Let's get in. Thank you.
the shrimp and grits. So it's Yellowstone brown grits. They're locally grown, milk, and then it's topped with the shrimp came from Georgia. You're eating today, so it'd be Georgia shrimp, house-made bacon lardons, and then we top it with it's got andouille sausage and an etouffee. We make our own etouffee in house, so it's topped with that. And that's probably my favorite thing on the menu.
Really nice.
Yeah, it was phenomenal. Combination of shrimp and grits, never had those before, and the way it was prepared was so good. So reminding me some of the French heritage with andouille sausage and bacon, and to finish a cheesecake was really delicious. Not too sweet, just perfectly prepared. Mouthful of cheesecake,
and it was cheesecake that is on the pecan trail.
Yes,
and so it has pecans on the top, and then it also had some marshmallows.
Right,
and it was really good. It was sweet potatoes, so that took away from the sugar, which actually made it really enjoyable and really nice to eat.
Oh, we're heading to more stops on the pecan trail, so
yes,
follow along. Beer made of pecan. That specific beer is called Pecan Gone Wild. Let's test it. Cheers! Wow, it's really smoky. Really great thing here is you can order actually beer by flights. You can order so 4 ounces, 6 ounces, and more, of course. And this is a 4 ounces, so this is a great way to sample a beer that you don't know.
We just walked in at Town Hall in Florence,
in downtown Florence.
Yes.
We are here for dinner. The ambiance is really dark, good ambiance, a really nice place. I'll show you around in a few seconds.
So this place is special because it is, they say that it's farm driven, southern inspired. So the menu, as we look at it, has a lot of traditional southern dishes. So you would find your mac and cheese, you have deviled eggs,
yes.
There's pork belly and scallops.
There's a bone-in pork chop, typically from the Carolinas.
Yes, everything from the fish, local fish as well.
They have also, so it's on the Pecan Trail as well. And so they offer several dishes that have some pecan, like they are pecan inspired. One of them I might have it tonight is the oxtail ravioli, and it's served with some pecan as well. And we have also a dessert with which is a pecan pie. Melting of chocolate. Mm. Wow. So there's a layer of pecan on the top. That makes it like really dense and full sweet bites. So it's not a light dessert. Really nice.